Hello students, today I am here with chapter 6 observing animals, class 5 EVS. Yesterday I have explained you about eating habits of animals. Again I am going to tell you about it. First, if we talk about herbivores are the animals that are plant eaters. They eat plants and plant products. Okay. And the next category is carnivores. Carnivores are the animals that eat other animals, or we can say they eat meat or flesh of other animals. And the examples are cheetahs, lions, tigers, leopards, foxes and jaguars. Now if we go to the third category of animals is omnivores. Omnivores are the animals which eat both plants and animals. Okay, the example is bear, raccoons, crows, eagles, etc. Okay, so human beings are also omnivores. Now moving to the next category, we have got scavengers in the next category. Such animals eat dead bodies of other animals. They are called scavengers, like hyenas and vultures. Now the next category is parasites. Parasites are the animals, they live in the bodies of other animals. They suck the blood of the other animals. They depend on the host animals for their food. Examples are mosquitoes and leeches. Now moving to the next topic of this chapter, food chain. We know that all living things depend on each other for survival. Plants and animals are living things and they need energy to survive. Plants depend on soil, water and sunlight for energy, right? Because they need soil to grow when they get proper water and sunlight. Okay, animals depend on plants or other animals for food and energy. As I have told you that herbivores eat plants and omnivores and carnivores eat other animals, that this dependency on each other is known as food chain. As you can see in this, first you can see grass, then the goat and the tiger. So this example shows that goat eats grass, it is herbivore, and the tiger eats goat, it is an carnivore. A food chain describes how different organisms each other. It starts with a plant and ends with an animal. Okay, so whenever you will see a food chain, first you will find a plant and the last one will be the animal. The goat eats grass and the tiger eats the goat. Now next food chain, the grasshopper eats grass. The grasshopper becomes food for the frog and the frog gets gobbled by the snake, and then the hawk eats the snail. So this is another food chain. Now if we talk about food web, the energy from plants get transferred from one organism to another in a food chain. Generally, most plants and animals are part of several chains. When we draw interconnected food chains, we get a food web. So many interconnected food chains become food web. Like in this picture you can see first green plant is given. Green plant is taken by a mouse, a rabbit and goat. Then jackal eats goat, wildcat eats rabbit, a mouse is eaten by rabbit, owl, snake. So see, many food chains are there in this and it forms a food web. Okay, so in the next video we will discuss about animal senses. That's all for today. Thank you.